Sometimes it could be hard to tell which features of a park are permanent and which are like temporary for the season. Okay, but I think this big guitar is maybe permanent for the park, with the license plates on it from various, from various states. Guitar made of garbage. But the Christmas lights on it are temporary. And then they have a carousel off to the side here, all made of red brick. I wonder where they got those brick. This guy off in the distance too is making an incredible noise, like he's sawing away. I think that's the library building right over there. Maybe not. They have a carousel with video surveillance to really assure you that they're watching closely. It's hard to say when they open it up. It's hard to say if this is a Christmas event or if this is actually a permanent thing. A lot of places they have permanent carousels. This doesn't look like something you could just easily remove. Children under 42? Under 42? What? Alright, I guess 42 inches. Note of food, bags must be left in bag area. No wet clothing. Now how's clothing gonna get wet? Is there a pool around? Oh, they ride free. Oh, but the partner has to pay. Okay. And then you pay $1 per ride. And I don't know who's gonna pay for 20 rides, however long the ride lasts. There are some crazy people out there that really get a kick out of certain rides. I watched this one Asian girl just all the time just swing on this swing while I was hanging out in the park in Rice Lake, even when it was 20 degrees out and colder in the teens. She was out there swinging away in the cold. You'd think it'd be too cold, but her need to swing was greater than what the cold could discourage. There's a lot going on around here. It's early Saturday morning. I'm gonna see if the food bank is open. They really built this area up. I guess these stones. Oh, it looks like they'll shoot water in here to make kind of a pool pond. That's pretty neat. Have a pool and the water just kind of runs through. So that's how people get wet. Have a way to cool down in the 100 plus degree weather around here. So this was kind of recent. They must have probably got these bricks from the local quarry. I don't understand what the purpose of this thing is. It's got a good echo to it. Oh, and then there's more water. They don't discourage people from going into the water. Yeah, these water little things are pretty popular in the south. Now this should be the library building. So, yeah, it's a pretty neat park. Well developed with grass. This grass needs a lot of watering too. In fact, they got four of these water irrigator things. Looks like they're gonna need to rededicate it. Visitors, welcome. Snow, I've read about snow. born in Vermont. Buffalo in the center. It looks like by the same artist who made the guitar. Yeah, there's a lot of art downtown. Buffalo over there in the center, made of garbage. It's like chain is used for his head. No parking between certain times. Oh, the water walk. Oh, and this must be the water. Kind of trickles a little bit, maybe down the whole road. There's a lot of art around here. Pregnant lady feeding chickens. What? Oh, plenty of places to plug in. I wanted to repower this iPod. Tabernacle, looks more like a church. I gotta go down one more road. No protesters in front of Wells Fargo today. Maybe because they're happy that the operation in Montana got halted. Driving in a steak? Probably a fence post. People love putting up fences. Wow, I could get on the highest floor of that and get a better view of the town. Stairs on the corner. This parking garage is actually free for the public. I could just drive in here. That's pretty cool. Just shows how unpopular this area is. I mean, if they built it in anticipation of extra busyness, and it turned out that it didn't get as busy possibly, because most of these places, they got to recoup their losses. Their expenses, I mean. I find it interesting how they made creative art out of old rusty tools. Okay, there is no food bank around here. There's a balloon in the air. I'm a little confused about this food bank then. It says 9 to 1, and I may have the wrong address. It may be giving a bad address. I don't have my iPad with me because I was anticipating food in my bag. So it's kind of a letdown there. It's 20 minutes to 9, so I still have a little time, but it's a hospital over there, not a food bank. It's next to the courthouse. This is quite a water walk. Got water flowing everywhere. a special place. Oh, watching the clouds. All right. So it's, his last name is Church. Okay, so the downside is they marked off a lot of spots for businesses in this parking garage. You just have to pay attention because you can get fined if they can figure out you didn't come over for the particular business. Sum up how the parking works. It's the businesses that get the shade, these shaded roofs on the edges, and public parking is in the sun, and that could be a downside in the summertime. Okay, maybe not so much in the winter. I have no problem parking in the open sun, no shade, like this. Oh yeah, there's a stairwell. Go down. Yeah, it's pretty nice of them to put this shade up, but yeah. I think there's some public parking on the lower levels too. It's not a matter of only having shade for the businesses. So that's about it. This guy's got a ladder in his vehicle. Yeah, it's not as great of a view as up on Sugarloaf. Wow, so they actually turn this water on this time of year. A little too chilly though. Smells strongly of chlorine. Okay, next to the parking garage, Zion Bank. Got several levels for each parking garage. Yeah, it's pretty well maintained. Like a flag. It's not exactly easy to see. Alright, even though the museum is closed for renovation, maybe I can check out this Brigham Young house. His winter home. He did more traveling than I thought. This should be it. He used to grow grapes Yeah, there's a sign. Oh, free tours. Wow. You go right on in. His winter home. And it's open right now. Big D. Antique show. There's a lot of historic stuff around here. They built quickly, I think. They had good experts that built quickly. You know what seems to me to be better than getting drunk is to be lost in a place I've never been before, and we'll have Google Maps to help relocate myself if I get too far off. This is good weather and I've never been here. It's all different. The Christmas lights add a little special entertainment as well. I'm just walking over to a grocery store. I'm kind of hungry. See what I can get. But it feels really good to just look at different stuff, new and different stuff right now in St. George. It's better than any drug. You know, I am feeling quite a bit of stress about the food stamps taking 7 to 10 days, business days, I think, for processing. And also the food bank just not being where the website said it's supposed to be. I'm paying for food out of my own pocket, and it's really starting to stress me out. Especially when I'm trying to buy good food. I need to really scale back on the quality again. Because this is really getting ugly. It'll be no time before I'm at zero with this pace. Now that I'm really getting squeezed in Utah.
Hey.
Alright, this is a Dixie Sun Bowl. I guess I never really paid close attention to how the gate systems work. They got several gates that I went through that kept open. But I didn't realize how strong of a spring these things are. And that pulls this latch up above and down below. This thing is like really strong. And that's going to keep in the bowls, of course. They don't have to lock it, I guess. Yeah, and it's also designed, I think, to maybe put on a rope. See, you don't open it right at the gate. Yeah, this thing, there's a spring. That's how it feels. That's probably what the springs look like. And this is where they put the bowls in. Man, that does not open easy. So this would be the room for when you have a bull or a horse. They have to lift up this foot gate thing and then I guess move this thing. So that's how they fit them in this small little square before they, which is strange, they release them onto grass. Normally I see it on dirt or something, dusty dirt. Maybe they're changing things up around here. Alright, so on the campus, gonna test to see if there's any internet for me at a possibly faster pace, and oh my god, they even have the Frisbee Golf right on the campus, mobile Frisbee Golf. This has gone too far. You know, I'm amazed how tired I've been feeling today. It's just, I got no energy, and it's been going on all day. I slept in the city, and water doesn't seem to go down very well. Like, I don't really crave the water here. I wonder if water has something to do with it, but I'm very low energy. Okay, well my energy is up now pretty good. I was just consuming, like it's 2 hours later, and I consumed the downer type of herbal drinks, such as the chamomile. I first had catnip. And then chamomile, and then I also ground up some celery seeds, and this thing too. I'm surprised how bitter celery seeds taste after you grind them up. But I had those, and I just had those three herbs, and then I took a nap, and feel much better. My energy is much better. I don't know where that fatigue came from, but. Just had to rest it off and try some different herbs. I think it's probably an energy thing, and changing up the herbs may help. Just watching these two black people out there. They're about in their 20s or so. It's a couple with two dogs. I've never seen someone handle their dog by just picking it up constantly. Of course, they got a Rottweiler, and then for a puppy, and then a bigger dog. I'm not sure exactly. It's one of them more higher class dogs. But this black guy picks up his dog a lot. I've never seen like so much interaction like that, where they pick the dog up a lot. Of course, there's no leash. This area, a lot of people just don't bother putting their dogs on leashes. And I also believe, I didn't look closely enough, but it looked like the dog took a poop and they didn't clean up after it. And this sign, underneath it, there's a encouragement to pick up after your dog. Yeah, that black guy, he's really hands-on with their dogs, with both dogs. So it's interesting. It's maybe encouraged to be more hands-on with the dogs, I'm not sure. Alright, so I think I might want to go to Walmart this evening. and then make a big hop south to the next library down, wherever that is. I'm just tired of this slow internet here. I like this area, but I can't work with this internet, so I really need to find some place that has a faster internet. And also the food stamps is very frustrating too. It's a nice area, but it's not friendly for people who use public services. Like an Uber driver. It's weird living in a tent for 2 years right here. And sugar increases your appetite. Waste your money on something like this seems ridiculous. It's like almost 8 a.m. in the morning. Nobody's on these rides. Yet they turned them on. Test them out because a Christmas tree went out. Maybe they're testing everything. Alright, returning back to the food stamps State of Utah office. $168. I thought there was going to be 7 to 10 business days, and now it's. I could have. All right. Well. Okay. I didn't know that it was going to be on Friday. I thought that I would have to wait 7 to 10 business days. Why would they? Why would? It's. Wow. Alright, well, a double surprise there. I was surprised to hear 7 to 10, and then I was surprised to hear you later retracted that. Okay. Well, I don't know why I'm calling then. Well, I just had to clear it up, I guess. I wasn't going to bother checking on my card, you know, because...
That's no problem.
So, alright, well, thank you.
Alright,
bye. Yeah, this natural desert wilderness really has a nice contrast of green and red. Green and red. It's pretty neat, just checking out the edge. I just hung out at McDonald's for about an hour playing Hearthstone to do the quest, the daily quest. And I finally, I got a pretty good pack. I got a new legendary, Krul the Unshackled. It's like release 3 demons from your hand when you play it, as long as you don't have any duplicates. So I have to look into a lock that has no duplicates. That's pretty decent.
Oh my god, that lady was just blowing her air blower right into the tree to knock more of the loose leaves down. I've never seen that done before. There she goes again. It may not be very visible, but she's just blowing leaves right out of the trees.